Hey everyone, Ryan here. Welcome back for more wrestling talk. This week, I would actually like to talk about an individual who's on the Friday night brand of SmackDown. His name is Cesaro. So he's been actually been around for quite a while as it is, but it's just, the reason I want to talk about this too, because on WrestleMania 37, he had a challenge with Seth Rollins, believe it or not. And ever since he defeated Seth Rollins, he's been really been pushed up to the top, which I'm glad he is, but it just seems like ever since he came in over like a decade or so ago, he's been amazing. He's been amazing ever since he came into the WWE in his in-ring debut. He, if you can remember, had faced Tyson Kidd as his first opponent, and he defeated him. And he, within the time, he's actually become a seven-time tag team championship with other people, Sheamus, Tyson Kidd, Shinsuke Nakamura. So Cesaro is really is on top of his game with his tag belt division. He's also had the U.S. championship belt as it is this as well. So the big thing I want to know is why now? It seems like everything he has done in the past, it seems like Cesaro should have had multiple shots at the belt. He should have been or Universal or maybe the other belt over on Raw. It should have been a while. It should have happened a long time ago, I should say. But he's getting a big push after what happened at WrestleMania 37 with Seth Rollins. But speaking of this match at WrestleMania 37 too, I want to point this out too, because for the yes, Seth Rollins has been making a big deal because he got swung 23 times. Oh my gosh. It's, believe it or not, that's not the record of from Cesaro, believe it or not. He's done 30 on it when he was a part of the NXT a while back ago. So, oh my, but still, this is amazing. If you guys can remember what he actually did at WrestleMania 37, he did a spinning UFO, putting Seth Rollins on his shoulder for a good amount of time. Oh my gosh, I got on my feet and I thought this was so amazing. I guess I wasn't the only one because everybody at the arena for WrestleMania 37 there in Florida really thought this was an amazing talent from Cesaro. And ever since then, his talent has been pushed up. He's been defeating people ever since WrestleMania 37. And for the last couple weeks, Daniel Bryan has actually been helping him out, trying to get noticed as it is. Because if you guys can remember too, because Daniel Bryan was in that triple threat match with Roman Reigns and Edge, and both Edge and Daniel Bryan did not win the belt. Unfortunately, Roman Reigns held on to that belt. But this big thing I want to really talk about is why now? Why Cesaro did not get the championship in the past? But I feel this could be a good match. But it's all depending on what happens this Friday, this as well too. Because if you didn't know, Daniel Bryan gets his second shot at Roman Reigns. But the big deal with this is if Daniel Bryan loses his belt, we have to say bye-bye, which I hope that's not the case because Daniel Bryan is such a talented wrestler as he is. But he is more like a saying bye-bye to the SmackDown side. So if that happens, he might go over the Monday Night Raw or something like that. But Cesaro is really the big attention I really want to talk about in this segment. He's a really talented guy. Okay, so you guys have to check this out because But back at WrestleMania 37, like again I said, Cesaro lifted Seth Rollins onto the shoulder and did that UFO spin. Check this footage out. This is really amazing, I gotta say. Now, isn't this cool? You can hear the fans in the background. Oh my gosh, this is amazing! And you can, of course, can't hear me because I was at my house, of course, watching this event. And I was really excited with what happened with this match. Seth Rollins is a great wrestler as he is. But, of course, Cesaro was the one that was on top. Okay, so if you have seen that footage before at WrestleMania 37, if you did watch it live, or if you were actually there, that would have been more incredible to actually see, be part of that crowd and going, oh my gosh, that's amazing. But leave some comments. I'd love to hear what you guys actually thought about Cesaro's big UFO spin against Seth Rollins. And I'm hoping this will be a good fighting chance for Cesaro to get that chance at the Universal belt, depending on what happens this coming Friday with Daniel Bryan and Roman Reigns. I think this is a big thing for Cesaro, and I think he's doing a really good job as it is. So, once again, I congratulate you on being the good wrestler you actually are. Cesaro is a good fighting champion, and I can't wait to see what's going to happen with the coming weeks. Maybe he can actually be the Universal Championship. Maybe he can actually say, Cesaro, Universal Champion! Yeah, something like that. That would be really cool, I got to say. But once again, WWE Universe, I want to know your reactions about this Europe's spin. What do you actually think what might happen with Cesaro? Will we actually be able to step up to the Universal belt and actually win it? That would be awesome, I gotta say. So once again, leave some comments down below. I'd love to hear what you guys gotta say. I can start wrapping things up saying, once again, thank you for watching Wrestling Talk. My name's Ryan. Make sure to give me a thumbs up, subscribe, and I will see you next time. I'll see you guys later. Bye.